Okay, you guys, come up to this beautiful bedroom underneath the wonderful sunlight and try for a baby, okay? Hey, you guys, welcome back to Some More Sims, and today we are going to be in Windenburg for some Sims 4 in the city.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I have a jumper on because it's actually quite cold. Like, the weather has really turned and it is cold in England. So we're gonna be going back to these little cutie pets with Charlie Rose, all grown up now. She's a proper little womanine, and you guys really like the way she looks. I'm very happy about that. Okay guys, get ready to do your little grooving. Hopefully it's gonna play as an intro. Oh yes it is, here we go. I also love her look. Like, she's so grown up. Like, it's freaking me out how quickly everybody's growing up. These are my baby's babies. These are my grandchildren, my baby's babies. And they are all grown up as well. Time has gone very fast, but who am I? Charlie Rose asked. She doesn't know what she wants to be when she grows up. Does she want to pick something she likes? She's got time, or she can study for a high-paying job. You know what? You literally grew up last episode, my love. You have time. You have lots of time. Oh, but you don't have any time to go for a wee. So you need to go. Get your butt to the toilet. That's right. Doing a little jog into the beautiful house. See, I like this series because at the moment, we can still kind of like build and play. It's like a dual sort of thing because we're still trying to build this house. Some of you guys were saying, just use cheats, Claire. Just use cheats and finish it off. But I kind of like saving and getting stuff. I do kind of like doing that for the house. And I'm really, really liking the way that the house is looking. So I can't wait to see how much more of it we can do this episode. So look, there's Selma. Is she actually going out and gardening on her own? She's going out to go and chat with them. Selma. Your plants do not look very happy. Please can you tend to your poor little garden? Look, do you like this little wheelbarrow I put? So Charlie's done her toilets. Now she's eating her burger. Oh my gosh, like literally, she is a babe. Like, I'm having a little bit of a crush on Charlie. She's beautiful. She is a beautiful, beautiful girl. I actually think, you know, she's so different to any of the Sims we've had before, but she could be my favoritest Sim yet. So I'm not sure whether to get her a little part-time job, because, you know, money is kind of tight. I've never made my kids have part-time jobs before, but I think it could be a good thing for Charlie. So here is her little room. She has room for a double bed, but we don't quite have money. We will definitely be improving Charlie's room in this episode. But guys, it always happens. It's 3 a.m. Can everybody please get their butts to sleep? Also, guys, I hope you have your peach juice prepared and ready to drink while we are playing The Sims. Oh my gosh, why is the restaurant open? It's been open for 86 hours. Oh my gosh, close it. I mean, we made £1,000, which is great, but still, close that restaurant. You guys have given me a really, really good tip on that, and that I can buy well-managed. Lowers the chance of bad events happening while your Sim is away. We need to save a lot of perk points for that, but that is the idea. That's what I eventually want to get to the point of being able to do. Like, Selma at the moment has to go in, but she actually isn't at work today. So she can pop into the restaurant and make sure things are running carefully. But eventually we kind of want to be able to not have to do that. So little Charlie Parley Pudding and Pie is up. She has class in 2 minutes. My gosh, woman, you left it late to get up. You're going to have to turn around and go straight to school, I'm afraid. Forget about the burgers. You are heading off to school. I think this is her first time going to school as a teenager, and I would like her right now to make some friends at school, okay? Let's see who she manages to meet. She's obviously got bestest pal forever, Kira, in there. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Look at the state of this kitchen. Wow. Selma, I'm going to help you out, but there's only so much I can do. You and James are gonna have to do a bit of tidying when you wake up this morning, because this is very, very messy. Because these two little googies, are they still sleeping? No, they're up. Okay, Selma, if you would like to get ready, I'll be able to bring you into the restaurant. Do your little wibbers. James, why don't you cook everybody some breakfast? Eggs and toast sounds wonderful, James. Why, thank you, friendo. Yum, yum, yum. Do you like this clock, by the way? I really like this beautiful clock that we've got in our kitchen. Look at these. Are they hearts of... I was going to say heart of asparagus. It's a heart of... Oh my gosh, that's going to annoy me so much. Ah! Oh guys, you know what I mean. I have them on my pizza. I really like them, but I can't remember what it's called. Selma! Selma, with the boots in worky mode. You know you're going to kill it at the restaurant today, Selma. so hot, Selma. James is cooking you breakfast. Forget taking a slice of cake, you spoon. Clean up this instead, okay? In fact, can you get yourself in a cleaning frenzy? There you go. Oh, look at James wanting to sit outside on this beautiful morning, even though he really needs a wee. So these cute little googies are having a nice little breakfast together, prepared by James, and then we're gonna head into the restaurant. I'm annoyed that we got it to quite a good point, and then we had to sell it. We had like two chefs, two waitresses. We were doing a really good job. We will get back to that, guys, I assure you. And then I have something very special planned for you two little cheekies in this episode. Oh. In fact, you have a day off. And it takes a little while to cook what I have in mind. So you guys, what I'm thinking is, I've wanted to do this for a really, really long time, but I wanted to make sure that everything else was in order. I would like these two little googies to have another wee baby. And since they both have a day off work, and it takes a little while to form a little googie egg inside of eggs, apparently are the thing with this episode. Don't know why, guys, but they are. It takes a little while to create a googie egg. So why don't these guys get to it now? In fact, James really needs a toilet. So James, do your little wheeze first, because I think that's going to interfere in what we need to do. Okay, you guys, come up to this beautiful bedroom underneath the wonderful sunlight and try for a baby, okay? You already have one absolutely awesome child. So why not try for another? That's what I'm thinking. So let's see, James has wanted this for actually quite a while. It's not one of his aspirations at the moment, but still, I think he's gonna be pretty happy with Selma's suggestion. Look at that, he's like, woohoo! I've been waiting years for this. Literally since Charlie was like a kid, maybe even a toddler. He has wanted another baby, but Selma's wanted to focus on her career. She made it to the top of her career and she's now got her own restaurant. So, you know, if that's not a picture of success, then I don't know what a picture of success is, because she's doing very well. Look, we can even perv on them in alt mode. You guys should never have told me about this. In fact, look at this, we could do this. And we can perv on them through the glass window. Look at those love hearts. You know it's going well, and look, you can't hear it. Can't hear it from out here. There we go. This is why my videos have been restricted on monetization, you guys. Because of woo-woos. Sweet, innocent, beautiful, life-giving woo-woos. Life-creating. Okay, so I'm not gonna make her take a pregnancy test. So we're not actually gonna know whether the woo-woos have been woo-tastic and successful until we see if a little baby is popping up. But however, she's been pleasantly satisfied, which is always a good sign. Okay, Selma, I'm gonna need you to go into work. Off you go, my little googie. Stop it with the eggs, Claire. Leave the eggs out of this. The only egg we care about is the one in little Selma's googie egg womb. I say that quite strangely. Okay, Selma, you need to change back into your banging business outfit, okay? There we go. So you're looking pretty fierce. Let's open up this restaurant. The restaurant is open for business and Selma Chops is here, which is great. Is there anything else we should be buying? What I would quite like is this fast eaters one and the lower training costs. Both of these would definitely be a big help. Okay, so all the little stuffings are running in. Please, can you get your butt inside there, lovely? Well, oh, clearing up. Why don't we pick this up? Oh, look, Charlie Rose has met someone at school. Why has she met a child? She is a teen. Oh my gosh, look. We still have Kira's cake here. Please, can we get things cleared up? Thank you very much. Can I like, oh my gosh, as if the cake is still there. Can we just clean everything up, okay? Then I'm gonna get some training paid for. The chef's take, oh look, she's met Aki at school. This could be another good friend. There we go. I'm not sure how much money we've got in the business. Okay, we don't have loads. So once I train the chef, which is 600, there's not really gonna be that much more money to train any other people, unfortunately. But the chefs being trained is pretty important, I would say. I can recommend a dish now, you guys. Why don't I recommend her that? I might as well just recommend her the most expensive things. Get the most possible money. 5 stars, you guys. We're doing a really good job. 5 stars over here as well. People think the prices are great, which makes me think I should increase them a little bit, but I'm kind of scared. Like, how much should I increase it by? I'm gonna do 200. 200%. It seems really high. Also, I know my hair looks kind of crazy. I had it all curled like 2 days ago. I'm like, those cars are going to stay here for a while. I went on one walk that was a little bit windy and my hair instantly straightened itself. My hair does not want to be curly, even though I really like curly hair. Salma really needs a wee, but the toilet's broken. So she's hired a repairman and hopefully he's going to come around soon. No, she's not going to wee herself in public. No! Oh my gosh. She just weed herself in public. Okay, I think we disallow new customers. Oh, poor Salma, she'll hate that so much. Okay, closing time, you guys. We made another £1,000, which I think is really good. And we've got a little bit of training going on with one of the chefs. It seems to be going well. Okay, everybody home, please. Out we go. Poor little Salma Rooney. There's been no growth in this little tum-tum region with Salma just yet. But hopefully soon. Okay, poor Salma Rooney. Let's get you I wish I had a bath to put you in. I think that would be even better. Take a shower. Then let's see if James, why don't James cook up some nice dinner for us all, okay? We have no money. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're gonna have to transfer a little bit of the fire and the flames back to the house. Just £100. Things are very tight at the moment, so that at least James can cook. Aww. Look at these two cutie pies. I'm so glad, like, literally their relationship is rock solid, you guys. It's a beautiful relationship. Kira, have you got some homework to do as well? That's grade school homework. I don't think we need that anymore. Hopefully you've done your real homework as well. Or you've hidden it somewhere. I don't know where she's... I've just called her Kira. No. Charlie, I don't know where you've hidden your homework, but you've done a pretty good job of hiding it. Nice family din-dins. I just like it when they all eat together. It makes me really happy. Oh, it's also a good chance to like, look at Selma's face and the way she looks. Look at James's face and the way he looks. And then see how it compares to like little Charlie at the end. I think it's like the best example we've had of like each child getting a little bit of each parent. I think so anyway. I think they look really, really cool. I'm happy with my little suburban family, you guys. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh, James! Did you just see that? He just fell through the floor! In those ugly shoes! You deserve them for putting those creations on. Look at them. Look at them! Okay, guys, so there still seems to be no baby on the cards quite yet. And try for a baby is... Oh, look. What? What is going on there? We have this phasing through the ceiling, which is never really what you want, is it? So let's just move this down a little bit. It's still there. Stop that. There we go. I don't know why it was being all cheeky like that. I like how it matches the lights. Pretty cool, you guys. Pretty good attention to detail there, Claire. So what I was gonna say is trying for a baby, it doesn't usually happen the first time you try. So I think these guys should give things another go. Keep trying there. This little baby chicken here, I was gonna say I can clean up, but Salma's done it for her. How is she ever gonna learn? No, wait, don't clean it up. It's all the food we have in the world. I need you to just put it away. Put that away. So these guys are gonna give it another go just to make sure that a baby is on the cards, you guys. You can't try and talk about vacuum cleaners to entice him into trying for a baby. That's not how things work. Okay, so those guys are definitely gonna go get their little woobers on. Kira, you don't wanna be, oh my God, it's 5:30 a.m. in the morning? What? Oh my gosh, my timing is very off in this. So let's get her upstairs and into bed. Those guys are woo-wooing. I wish it was like the previous Sims games where if a baby was on the cards, it would go do-do-do-do-do-do. Little baby noise. Time for school. Butts out of bed. School needs to be gone to. Well done. And I don't even think you've got your homework, have you? What are you like, you nutcase? Keep making friends, okay? Maybe we invite this Aki girl around this evening. She's met Siobhan as well, who's in the Paragons. I just realized that Hajar was obviously her grandma. She doesn't have a grandma anymore, which is really sad. But she's still got Claire, Grandma Claire. Okay, Salma, I think it's time. We've done, look at these stupid windows. We've done two try for woo-woos. I think it's time for you to take a pregnancy test, okay? Let's see what the pregnancy test is saying. Do your little wee wees. She's like, fingers crossed. You guys, okay, Okay, she's eaten for two. There's going to be a new addition to the household. And she's told him. She's gone straight inside to go and tell him. Oh, did you see her little... Ah, I love that. Little happy tops, happy tops. Okay, okay. Pause the game right there. Where's my phone? I need to remember what you need to eat for a boy because I definitely want to get a boy this time. So... let me quickly go get my phone. I'll be back. Okay, so to have a boy, we need to eat carrots and listen to the alternative music on the radio. We can definitely do that, you guys. I don't know if we even have any music playing devices in the whole of the house at the moment. I'm gonna see if we can afford a stereo to put in this room. Because I really, really want to have a little baby boy. It's been so long. We've had so many girlies. Oh my gosh, okay. We need a tiny bit more money, but I can get that one with just a tiny bit more. So why don't we just quickly transfer another 100. Oh gosh, okay, 100. From the fire and the flames. There we go. And then I can get that little radio. There we go. So if I just pop that in here, I think it's quite nice having a little stereo in the kitchen anyway, like listening while you work. I don't know if I have any carrots planted. I don't. You know what she could do? Actually, James could do this. He could harvest all of these trees and then we can at least sell the money from them. Farmer, veggie and herbs. We just need the starter vegetable pack, I think. Yes, okay. So that has a carrot in it. So let's get some carrots on the go. No, they've not given us a carrot. Guys, they didn't give us a carrot. Okay, let's try this again. I'm gonna go for the farmer. I'm gonna go for, can I afford it? I can't afford anymore. No! How am I gonna get a carrot? At least you can listen to. Let's listen to some alternative radio and grab yourself some foodies. Oh, she is meant to be going to work. Can we not get maternity leave now? Take a vacation day. You still get paid. Yes, okay, we've got some things in our inventory to sell. Perfect, so we can get a little bit more money. You've got more harvesting to do yet, James, lazy bum. Keep going. And then let's try buy another pack that's hopefully gonna have a carrot in it. Farmer pack. Give it an open. Yes, okay. Carrot, perfect. Let's get that planted. I don't really want to plant any of these other ones, so I'm just gonna sell them. James has got work in an hour. That's actually awesome because it means he is gonna get some money. Oh, it's Friday. Charlie's done with school for the week. I feel like she's doing pretty good at school. I can never find her homework though. Oh, she's doing okay. She needs to get a skill to level 3. So you're gonna have to work on some kind of a skill. I'm not quite sure what you're gonna do yet, but you need to work on something. Okay, we've got Salma in here listening to alternative radio station. She's grooving. She's getting down to those baby boy vibes. Oh, wow, okay, okay. She's really getting down to those baby boy vibes. Oh my gosh, we can pay the bills, you guys. We actually do have enough money. Okay, James, pay those bills. That's from James doing a good job at work. In fact, did he get a raise or something? Oh, he did, he got a bonus. James, you are so good. Literally so good at the old worky bobs. Why don't you pay the bills though? What is that all about? There we go, guys. Bills have been paid. At 3 a.m. in the morning. Bit of a weird move there, James. Bit of a weird move. Actually, James, you know what? Since you're up and you're going to be ready early, I think we open... Oh my gosh. What is going on with that toilet? I think we open up the restaurant for an early session. James has got work at 3. So we could do like a sort of an 8-hour shift at the restaurant for a little bit more money there, you guys. Okay, so James is going to be opening the restaurant today. Let's get you looking super smart, my love. Boom, there we go. Looking pretty tidy there, son. Which makes that kind of weird that I just said that. Oh my gosh, I know where her homework is. It's at the restaurant. Charlie Rose's homework is at the restaurant because I remember her doing it at Kira's birthday. Wow, okay, so... I am gonna get James to bring it home and give it to her. As if she's done that. She left it at the restaurant to try and get out of doing her homework. What an absolute peak cheeky. Ali is here, yay. Look at him, giving his old dad a hug. I love that they've come here. Let's give Mummy Bear a hug as well. The service at this place is fantastic. Well, it is your son, so, you know. Guys, a teen. let's get James introduced to him so that potentially he could, is that weird? Bringing home random men from your work for your daughter to hang out with. It's a little bit weird, but at least we're gonna know him. I mean, he seems like a stand-up guy. Look at this. He's got his nice little suit on. I think he's the kind of teen we could make look good as well. What's he called? Isaiah. Okay, remember that name, you guys. Okay, so Charlie's here now. James is going to work. But can Charlie manage this restaurant? Oh my gosh, you guys! Charlie's gonna have a part-time job looking after the restaurant! Best day ever! Okay, you probably need some better clothes, you know. Okay, I am gonna have to just give her some restaurant-worthy clothes, I think. Okay, so this is a second outfit that she can wear for work. And let's go with something quite casual like this. Or like this. I kind of want something a little bit cooler than that. Because she, you know, she's the owner's daughter. Just saying. So I'm gonna give her these little booties and I'm gonna give her this outfit instead. And I think she probably, can I get a hairstyle that lets her like tie her hair up for work? Damn, she's so pretty. Okay, so I think that hair color is fairly similar to her own. And just like putting it in a bun for work, you know? That's kind of a big bun though. I think I might hate that. Actually, there we go. So she's got it in a plait. I mean, no, that's about the right length as well. Okay. So she's got it up in a little bit of a plait for work. I don't think there's a hair color that's exactly the same as her own, unfortunately. But it's pretty close. There we go. So she's at least got her little work outfit now. And then I love this because she can actually like help out at the restaurant. Which means we can keep it open a little bit longer. But you need to do some welcoming, okay? And do some checking up on. So it's like she has got a little part-time job. Okay, I mean, she's still a teenager though, you guys. So she's not going to be quite as good at working as her parents are. In fact, right now, she's ringing her friends and chit-chatting with them. But still, she's making an effort. At least she's got a part-time job helping out the fams. Oh, poor little thing. Okay, she's pretty tired after that. I mean, it's kind of mean making your kid work on a Saturday night. I'm not going to lie to you there. Salma's been all pregnant and whatnot. Have you got some carrots to eat yet, Salma Rooney? Ah, they're so close, but they're not quite harvestable. Okay, you need to come and listen to your music. Oh, look at this little cutie pie. Doing some little basketballing for herself outside. I like that. Why don't you do it somewhere with James? And I have some money to burn. I have £5,000. So I think I might decorate. Kind of want to do a living room, you guys. I know Charlie's room needs finishing off yet, but I want a living room. So what I actually want is a big, huge, huge TV on that wall. But I don't know if we can like quite afford one yet. We can, but it's going to take up all my money. But that wall's just begging for a big TV. Or we could do like this kind of a dealio instead and have like a TV on that, like that. That could be pretty cool too. But no, I think I want the big TV. I'm sorry you guys, but I want the big TV. And I've got some pretty cool sofas. I mean, this one's got a deer cushion. You know the deer theme in this house is strong. In fact, we need some lights in this room. Oh no, I've run out of money. I wanted to put a little side table here. Okay, this room is gonna have to be like a work in progress type dealio. We'll get some more money soon, you guys. Don't worry, your cute little faces. Okay, Salma, I think that's quite enough dancing to alternative. I'm trying really hard to make sure that we have a boy this time, you guys. So she's done enough of that for now. Let's get to sleep and hopefully there's gonna be some carrots for us to eat tomorrow. Let's check on Salma's pregnancy. She is in the second trimester. She reaches the third trimester in 14 hours time. Now I wanna stay with her for the whole time because you miss out on the giving birth of the baby if you're not careful. So I definitely want to be there for it. Oh, she's woken up needing a wee. Yeah, that's gonna happen when you're pregnant, Salma Rooney, I'm afraid. So this little pie is making everybody breakfast. We've still got the alternative radio playing. Because, you know, I'm pretty desperate for the boy at this point. Why don't you sit here and have a little chat with her? Oh, that's so nice, cooking for a little mum and dad. I think it's the first meal she's ever made. And these two little cutie pies are just hanging. Oh, they were just hanging. Salma's really hungry. Salma, stop trying to eat cake, okay? She's just about to give you your breakfast. Have some patience. No, I'm not letting you eat cake for breakfast. Ridiculous. Ridiculous activities. I'm liking this music. And then I was kind of thinking maybe Charlie Rose can invite some of her girly-whirly friends around today for a little bit of a pool party. So this is one big benefit of this place. You all get to hang out and swim and stuff together. Her swim gear is pretty weird, but still. It's pretty nice all being able to hang out at the pool. Especially for these two little bestest friendies. Look how cute these guys are. I love them so much. I love that they've always been like bestest friends. Oh, they just became best friends forever. Cutie pies. Oh my gosh, when your dad gets in the pool with your friends and you're like, Dad, just stop this, it's embarrassing. But then when it's awkward because your dad looks like James and all your friends end up fancying your dad. Oh my gosh, look at this. James has got all the teenage girls fawning around him. Oh, look at these cutie pies. Oh, I love that. Little James, move out the way, Charlie. We want to watch this cuteness. He's feeling her little tum-tum. I love that. Little bubbas. Salma's looking super pregnant now, actually, you guys. I don't think we've got that long to wait. Salma's been the first person in the whole of the house to watch the TV. And of course, she's watching some sort of cooking competition. Salma, you would smash it if that was you, okay? I just know you would be the best. Okay, I've got to listen to Alternative again. She's in her third trimester. I'm so scared of it not being a boy, you guys. Please, please, please be a boy. I know you're sick of listening to the music, but you're gonna have to. James came home with some money to spend on the house. Thanks, James. Oh, I like those dining room chairs. Look at these cool little living chairs. A coffee table. Okay, I'm trying to find some cool stuff to put in here. I'm kind of thinking it's gonna be a bit of a, a little bit of like a brown and black room. That's my kind of initial thoughts. You guys know how much I like my little poofs. Okay guys, I've had a bit of a rethink of the room, as you can probably tell. And I'm just changing some stuff around. I just want to see how it looks, because I like the idea of a cool statement fireplace. I'm trying to figure out a way to do this without the furniture looking really parked. I changed where the arch of the door was, and I like the TV more like that, and I like that fireplace. But I'm just struggling to get everything fitting in. Because I want like this little cozy area to do some fires and books. And then this is like the little TV area, but I might have to get rid of the poof, which would be really sad. Okay, guys, I think I'm done. Okay, I'm gonna have to go into it to show you. I think that's gonna be the best way. It's changed quite a lot. I think I'm happy with it. I always find like, this is gonna take ages. I always find like living rooms quite difficult. And this one's a bit of a strange shape. But here is the way it looks. So you've got like this little fire and sort of chill out area here. Well, these little pictures, a little packed bookcase there. You're looking forward into like where the table is now, which I think is quite good. And then you've got like this little sort of, look, a little Salma Rooney sleeping a little hard out. You've got this sort of like a sort of TV area here. So I think it's quite a good mix. You guys are going to have to let me know in the comments below, but I think it's looking good. However, oops, I did not mean to press that. I am completely spent up now, so I have not saved enough money for a baby room. I have just realized. Oops. Oh my gosh, I can harvest the carrot. Harvest it quick. Harvest that plant and eat those carrots. Okay, forget harvesting the rest. You've got 6 carrots to eat. Eat them all up. Okay guys, she's eating carrots. She is eating up her carrots, so fingers crossed. Cross all of your fingers for a boy. And I don't really want twins, so don't be crossing your fingers for those, okay? Oh my gosh, guys, I just had more bills, and I spent all the money on the living room. Oops! Pregnant swims with Salma. Oh my gosh, you guys. She is so pregnant right now. Let me just actually fully appreciate the pregnancy tummy. Oh my gosh, that is huge. That is one huge, oh my gosh, we went through the wall. That is one huge, huge, huge pregnancy tum-tum. I think we're definitely gonna pop today, you guys. Today is the day. Salma is bursting with anticipation to meet her new bundle of joy. Guys, she's gone into labor. We need to go to the hospital. People need to join her. Can it just be one person? I think it can only be one person. Yeah, okay, it's just James. Not Ali, which is what happened with Salma's first baby, Charlie Rose. What's happening? Cross everything for a boy, you guys. We're doing this business. We need a boy. We need a boy so badly. Look at her in her swimsuit for the baby. Literally in her swimsuit. Is this guy going to be the person having my baby? James, do you want to get us checked in, please? Okay, James is checking us in at the hospital. Selma, you should probably come over here as well. I think she's just meeting her doctor. I think he is going to be our doctor today. Yep, Dr. Jerome Hirsch with his little top knot. Okay, I think we're all checked in. Look at her pregnancy boobs, though. Oh my gosh, Selma. I can't get her to, like, go and do the baby. And how do I make her do that? Or maybe she's giving birth at this one? Guys, how do I make her give birth? It's never been this difficult before. Okay, okay, she's going over here. Okay, okay, pause, pause, pause. Riku, definitely not the time. Get here right now, James. Guys, it's happening. James, where are you? They always bug out at the hospital, I swear to God. Okay, guys, he's on his way. He is on his way. I'm gonna actually view it from this point of view. I've never done this before. James, please tell me you're about to walk through those doors or else Selma is gonna cry right now. I mean, look at her face. She's definitely not very happy. James, where are you? Oh my gosh, it's a boy. Yes, yes, yes. I have not thought through what I'm gonna be calling the boy at all. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. I can't believe James wasn't in the room. The men of this sim world and not great the whole birth thing. Okay, I think I'm gonna call him, what's a cute name for a boy? I'm thinking Connor. I really like the name Connor. It's like a little Irish name. I also like Joey. No, I think I'm gonna stick to my Irish roots, you guys. It's gonna be Connor. Connor is actually, he is. Oh my gosh, it's gonna be a triple barrel name. I can't fit it all in. Okay, I think we'll go Calorie. I think he's going to be a Calorie Aiken. I think that Charlie Rose might be an Al Arabi. So Connor is going to be Connor Calorie Aiken. That's a very Irish name. At least it starts very Irish. Oh, he's here. He's here, you guys. She's not on her own. He's freaking out hard. And there's little baby Connor. Hello, Connor Calorie. Connor Calorie. There you go. Connor Calorie. Little baby Connor. Here he is, the little cute baby. James is, oh my gosh, what is James doing? What just happened? Okay, time for you guys to go home and show a little baby to Charlie Boozy. Okay, where's my baby? Where's the baby gone? Where is he? Oh, he's here floating. Floating next to a... Charlie Rose's bed. Okay, so I think while he's a little teeny tiny baby, I am gonna keep the little crib in the room with us. Just cause it's a little bit easier to kind of keep an eye on him while he's here. Oh no! I wanna make it that color cause it's perfect. But the script call fails, you guys. And I've got a really cute nursery planned for him when he's a little bit older. Put a little bear in his crib for him. There we go. Oh my gosh, you guys, look at this, look at this, look at this. It's a little picture of him on the wall. Oh my gosh, I can't handle. Okay, I need to grab the actual baby now, don't I? Always helpful if you put the baby in the crib. Oh my gosh, where did he go? Can I change the color of the baby? Oh my gosh, I can't. No, I can't. That's so weird. You'd think it would let you change it. Okay, there we go, you guys. Let's just get everybody up here to come and see him. Oh, there's Jamesy Bobs checking out his new child, his first son. Oh, they're all here now, you guys. I'm kind of thinking the baby probably needs a little bit of attention. Can I kind of do this? It's a very strange view, you guys. But that's the whole now Calorie Aiken Al Arabi clan. There is quite a few of them now. But how cute is that? I mean, Charlie Rose doesn't look that happy, but they've got a beautiful new son. Selma's already like a little stick insect again. Charlie Rose does not seem very happy about this new addition to the family, but I'm sure she'll be loving her brother very soon. So there we go, you guys. A new baby has been born. It's Connor Kaleri Aiken. There you go. Selma. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of In the Suburbs. I shall see you in the next one. Bye.